Welcome to Learnpedia, the ultimate JEE and NEET prep tool currently being used by more than 20,000 aspirants. Now, take a look at this actual JEE question and see if you can answer it. If you think you got the answer, post it in the comment section below. To understand the concept behind this question, go ahead and watch this video further.
We will calculate moment of inertia of a thin disk about the center perpendicular to the plane. That means we want to calculate about z-axis. So I have shown you here x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. About this axis in the plane xy, the disk is revolving or rotating. We want to calculate moment of inertia about the z-axis. To calculate moment of inertia about the z-axis, consider a disk of mass m radius r rotating about this z-axis and take out an element of radius small r width dr in the shape of a ring. Mass of disk, let us say m, radius capital R. If radius is capital R, from here at a distance of small r, generate a ring of thickness dr. This is the ring which we have cut. Radius of the ring is small r and thickness dr. Choose an element of radius small r width dr. So what is the mass of this element? Dm. Dm will be total mass of the disk by its area pi r square into area of this element 2 pi radius small r into thickness dr. 2 pi r is the circumference into thickness dr, that will give you dm. Moment of inertia of this ring element about the axis, we know I is equal to mr square. So this will be di is equal to dm is the mass of the ring into the radius of the ring is r, so r square. So let us substitute value of dm in this. Moment of inertia of whole disk I is equal to integration r is a variable 0 to capital R dm into r square, or integration 0 to r. Will substitute the value of dm, m by pi r square into 2 pi r dr into this r square. So altogether I will be equal to m by this pi cancels out, so 2m by r square taken out, integration 0 to capital R, we are left over with now r cube dr, which you will get it as 2m by r square into r to the power 4 by 4, lower limit 0, upper limit r. So we are going to get substitute the value of small r as capital R. I is equal to mr square by 2. This is the moment of inertia of the whole disk about z axis passing through the center of mass, about the axis passing through the center perpendicular to plane. What we have done over here is we have taken the starting point as the moment of inertia of the ring. So we know the moment of inertia of the ring is mr square. Now we have taken this complete disk and we divided the disk into small rings. One such ring I have shown you. Radius of this ring is small r, thickness is dr. Then the mass of this ring is dm. So in place of capital M, we are going to place dm. And the radius of the ring is small r, so instead of capital R, we'll put it as small r square. This is the moment of inertia of a thin ring, di is equal to dm into r square. This becomes our starting point. Now first we calculated the value of dm. Dm will be mass by area into the area of the ring, m by pi r square into 2 pi r dr. Substituting value of I, integration 0 to r dm r square, m by pi r square 2 pi r dr into r square. So we get it, after integrating and substituting the limit, we get moment of inertia of the disk is I is equal to m r square by 2. So what is angular momentum or moment of momentum? Angular momentum of a particle about a point is defined as, this is the axis of rotation, or this is the point we have considered. This is the particle of mass m which is at a distance of r. The linear momentum of the body is p. Linear momentum is given as mass into velocity. So tangential velocity of the particle at this point is v. Correct? So the angular momentum of a particle is about a point is defined as L vector is equal to r cross p for anti-clockwise rotation. It is the product of linear momentum and the length of the perpendicular to the line of the linear momentum from the fixed point. Here, if we take the momentum vector is perpendicular to r, or in any direction if we consider, it's a cross product of r and p. Vector r is the position vector of the particle with respect to the given point, whereas p is the linear momentum of the particle relative to the point. Angular momentum of particle describing circular motion. Now suppose this is a particle which is moving in an anti-clockwise circular motion like this. From the axis of rotation, the body is revolving in anti-clockwise rotation. The distance of the particle is nothing but the radius vector r cap. Now the momentum of the particle, since it has a tangential velocity here, is p cap. Then for anti-clockwise rotation, L vector is equal to, we know, r vector cross p vector. P vector is along the tangent. Magnitude of L vector will be equal to r p sine theta. If theta is equal to 90 degrees, as in this figure, p is tangent, r is the radius, angle theta is 90. So magnitude of angular momentum will be r into p, where p is m into v. V is the tangential velocity. We can also write as in terms of angular velocity omega, as v is equal to r omega. Then we can write this one as r into m into v, or r into m into r omega. Angular momentum can be written as m r square omega. Since we have only one particle here, mass of the particle is m, so mr square omega. Mr square is nothing but the moment of inertia of the body or of the particle. So it can also be written as L is equal to I omega. So in analogous, linear momentum is mass into velocity. V is the linear velocity, and angular momentum is I into omega. Omega is the angular velocity. In linear direction or translatory motion, linear velocity is V. In rotatory motion, angular velocity is omega. Mass is the measure of inertia in the translatory system. Then here in rotatory system, I is the measure of inertia, or it is called moment of inertia. So angular moment of the particle describing circular motion, L is equal to I omega.
Hey there, hope you understood the concept. Here's the solution to the question asked at the beginning. Found this video useful? Hit the like and share icons to enjoy more such videos. LearnPedia's JEE and NEET prep tools contain more than 4,000 questions and over 20,000 solved examples. These can be accessed online through our website or offline through an SD card or a pen drive. To buy now, visit www.learnpedia.in. You can also try a free demo of our product before buying.